Hello, my name is Anthony Hall, and in this tutorial we're going to be following on from my first tutorial on how we created this little 3D room and how we're going to UV texture it. So I've got a 3D room, it's all on one layer. With this model there's also only one UV, so what we're going to do, sorry, one surface. So what we're going to do is use this one surface, one UV, one layer to UV it all. So let's get started. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to make sure I'm on the polygon tool, hold shift, and I'm going to select the two inside walls and the bottom. I'm going to go to UV, make UV, let's call it 3D room. And for this, just because I find it easy when it's basic objects, let's just change it to Atlas. Click live update, which gives us this, and then just click create. So I'm happy with that. Let's just drop these sections, and this one here, because it's the same wall, let's just put it up here, look, so it's next door to this. If you want, you can switch them around, but it's up to you, like so. Okay, so we've got these bits. So let's do the same with, let's go and make this inside window. So while we're on UV, make UV, leave it as the same UV. This time let's do it as a planar, live update, and let's check which one it's through. And you can see it's through the Z. But it maximizes it to the full length of and width of the actual UV. So I'm going to click on manual. And where it says X and Y, I'm going to check the largest amount, 2.4, and I'm going to copy and paste it into the Y. So it gives us a rectangle, and then click create. And again, what I'm going to do is modify size. I'm going to size it down to roughly the size of the window, and then just place it up here out of the way. So next we've got, let's do the door. So we'll click the door. I'm going to click both sides. So what I'm going to do is when I actually UV this, it's going to look like there's only one UV because they're on top of each other. But I'm going to leave it like that because I just want the same texture for both sides. So again, UV, make UV. Let's click on live update. This time it's going through the X. And look, if you look, the largest area is the Y. So let's paste that into there like that. So you get this. And then let's, again, size it down. Remember, there's two here. You can, if you want, just deselect one and move the other one to the side. But I don't need to for this stage. If you notice, when I moved it as well, they were kind of joined together like this. So if you want to stop that, you can actually unweld it and do it if you want, but I don't need to because I want them to be on top of each other like so. So got the window, floor, two sides. The last bit is the frame. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select a polygon and then press four at the bracket key. So under connections, look, or selection, sorry, connected, it will select everything to do with it. So if I just do that again, so select one, connected, and then I'm just gonna, for this I just want it to be a basic wood, so I'm gonna crudely, again, let's do a Atlas, so you get all these little bits which I'm not too bothered about, like so. And then I'm just gonna move it to the side, and I'm gonna size them down like so. And then I just need to find some way to put them here. So what I'll do for the time being is let's move this window out like so. And then let's move all this up here. In fact, I always like to not having it touching the edge too much. So let's just bring it in very slightly. The window itself, we could, if you remember it's here, you could just put it inside here. So let's just zoom in and place it actually in here, so we know it's actually there. And then let's select all this, let's bring it over. So now what I want to do is I want to just fit it so it's in here, not interfering with anything else. So if we put it there, let's select the door, move it to here. So yeah, slightly crude, but what we've got is, we've got everything I'm going to texture here. Now, I could make them smaller, maybe, and then do the outside as well. But for this tutorial, I'm just going to concentrate on the stuff we can see as if we're seeing it through the camera. But for yourself, if you want to UV texture the rest, you can. You just need to make this a bit smaller and be a bit creative with how you lay your UVs out. So next step, I'm going to go to the IO tab, and I want to take this into Photoshop. So export EPS. I don't want the grid, so I don't want these cubes, and I only want the UV texture. If you leave it on all of the above, it'll take all four through, and then I just need to say where I'm taking it through. So I'm taking it through to here, and I'll leave it as the, what I've called it, a start, and then press OK. So next bit, let's open up Photoshop. Now Photoshop's open, let's go to File, Open. Let's choose my EPS, press Open. When this comes up, you can leave everything the same. One thing you need to change out, and don't worry if your settings are different, is don't leave the RG, don't leave it on CMYK, that's for print. So what you need to do is change it to RGB, then press OK. And there we have it. So now what I've got to do is put my textures in each part of this UV so we can texture in Lightwave. So I'm going to open up the first texture, and here we have it. And so I've collected these textures, different ones. Let's start with the wall. So I've got this wall texture, and so I'm going to use this for my walls. Incidentally, here's where I've got my textures from. So texture.com, you get like 15 or credits a day, I think it is, for free, or you can buy them. But it's free to be a member, and then you can come down here, and if I wanted windows, click on windows, and you can have a look for all the different categories and so on. So good site to use. So just going to start by drag and dropping this over here. What I'm going to do is I'm going to make it so free transform it. Let's just make it so it fills in this wall area, and I'm just overlapping the actual line itself of the UV, so I know where the wind is going to go. What I could do is I could turn it down like so, the opacity, and maybe just cut a hole in it here like so, so I just know where to put the window when I bring it through like that. So let's just do the window so it's out of the way. Again, I've picked a window and bring it over. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to repeat this process by literally bringing it over each texture and placing it in, or over, shall I say, the UV area. So floor, the door, and then a basic wood for the wall frame. So at this part, I'm just going to skip to the end bit. Okay, so I've dragged and dropped all the layers in, and if I just turn them all off, you can see they're covering the UV bits. So I'm happy with that. I'll turn layer one off with the grid on, with the UV on, and I'm just going to save it as a JPEG into my image folder. We'll call it, I'll leave it at start, press save, leave it at maximum quality, and then let's go back into Lightwave. So let's see if this works then. So all the room, all the texture, look, so if I just press Q on my keyboard to bring up the surface editor, is assigned to that one texture, and I've got one layer and I've got one UV. So I'm going to double click the start texture, go to add node, image, drag color to color, double click it, the node, bring in the actual layer I've just created, which is called start, like so. I'm going to say for mapping, it's a UV map, and there's only one map, which is this one. So when I put it on, here it is, like so. So let's just have a look at that. And let's just go on to just texture. So I've got our walls, floor, the door frame. Now you can see here on the door frame, there's a few little white lines, so you might need to go back into Photoshop and make sure you overlap in right, and there's no, because that if that happens, that's usually because there's a gap somewhere that I've not covered in your Photoshop document. But for this stage, I'm okay. So if I wanted to, like I said before, I could come through here and I could get a wood, a wall texture and so on and so forth. So if I just open up a finished version like this, same thing, but I've just gone and textured the outside like so with a different texture. And then if we just have a look, here's the UV, and this has got the outside on as well, like so. So kind of a low poly 3D room, and then you can start adding stuff in. I mean, if you're very creative, you can make this a lot smaller. In fact, you could probably squeeze it all into the top corner here and have all your furniture on here as well, and I've still have one UV. So yeah, that's it. Hopefully you've enjoyed it and understood it. Thanks for listening. Look out for my next video.